I wanted to ask one easy question. When did India got independence? Anybody from the floor?
Not yet.
That's lovely.
Not yet.
Now a tough question. Whether India really got an independence? Whoever feels India has really got an independence, can you raise your hands?
She has already answered.
That's excellent. Dear Toastmaster of the day, most respected area director, fellow Toastmasters and beloved guests, good evening.
Good evening.
This is a serious question at this point of time, whether India has really got a freedom from British or not. We all know that India has been ruled by British over 300 years. How they conquer India, whether they came with a big army and made a big war like a Kurukshetra? No.
East Indian Company.
In the year 1600, British owned the East India Company was granted a charter to India to do trading business. They brought bands of sea pirates to India masked as merchants. These sea pirates, they captured the shores of India and set up armed forts in the primary parts of all over India. That's how they captured India. But in the year 1857, due to their high revolt, these people, they simply tricked and cheated Indians by the simple name change games. They declared East Indian Company was abolished and India was directly under the administration of Crown. When we say crown, we were under the impression it is like a king or queen. But the fact is, crown means it's a crown corporation UK, headed by a person named Rothschild. In the year 1947, when there was a big pressure from the freedom fighters, they again played a same name change game. They just declared India has been given an independence under the supremacy of first Prime Minister of India. But whatever strong footpath they have made in the India, whether has it been eliminated? From the day, since the day of so-called independence till today, what is going on in India? More than 90% of Indians were either attracted or addicted towards certain brands of products. None of the Indians were able to separate themselves from these kind of branded products. Right from the early morning when they wake up from the bed till they go to sleep at night, all these products have become their routine life. For brushing, Colgate, Closer, Pepsodent, Sensodyne, for shaving, Gillette, Max, Godrej, soaps, Lux, Rexona, Lifebuoy, and many more, Palmolive, shampoos, you name whatever leading brands, and beautification products, Pond's, Johnson & Johnson, Jergens, Fair & Lovely, and if you want to have breakfast, Kellogg's Corn Flakes, Quaker Oats, and Nestle owned Maggie. Health drinks like Horlicks, Bonvita, Boost, even Gulkan D. If you want to talk to someone, Airtel, Vodafone, in the answers, Nokia, Samsung, LG. If you name all the branded products whichever Indians are using in their day-to-day life, these are all either directly or indirectly owned by Crown Corporation of London. Most of these products are coming under Hindustan India Limited. When we hear the name Hindustan, it gives the impression it is a owner, it is an Indian owner or Indian government as a owner. But the fact is, Hindustan India Limited later changed their name as Hindustan Lever Limited, is directly reporting to Unilever Group. Hindustan Motors is owned by General Motors Company. All this Hindustan Unilever Group or many pharma products, whatever pharma products you all selling in the market, all are coming under Crown Corporation, who has looted our health and wealth, who has looted our pride of India, Kohinoor Diamond, which is now dead. Feel India has got a real independence, please raise your hands. For those few of people who are still not convinced, I want to unwrap some bitter truth. Please hold your breath. We are all thinking our money will be safe in State Bank of India, Life Insurance Corporation of India. All these are not having full control by government of India. Even Reserve Bank of India is controlled by Rothschild. Some of the handouts which I circulated, it will show a lot of other brands owned by Rothschild. We can make sure whether we can live our day-to-day life without these brands. My purpose of the speech is not to create caution among us, but to create consciousness among all of us. We have to delete their footprint, whatever they have installed in our country. We have to know where we stand. Only then, when we know where we are now, we can set our destination and we can plan our path. So, over to you, Toastmaster.
So those things were really important for us to know, and in particular the audience were awesome. They were watching, what is telling them, something new information comes. Most of the people feel that we got freedom, but he was proving with a lot of facts that India has not got freedom. So that is good. But this is a gentle topic. So for when you are doing some research, you should be a little bit specific. So you are talking about only one part that is only with the economics. So there are a lot of things as we have to mention about it. If you tell, we have lost independence, what about the our freedom of speech? We got, and sometimes we have in the problem in the borders. So all those things, if you could highlight those things, how that fact you should have proved that one, so that the audience has to listen, because you are proving in only one way. So what about the other things that you should have concentrated? And for the vocal variety part, so the your tone is very good. Your voice is very loud voice, which can, it's a commanding voice. So, but when you say other points, you have to show some variety, so that they have to connect with your emotions, so that will reach the audience. And what I liked in your speech is it was well organized, and it is, and they gave a lot of new information for the public. So, and all the Toastmasters enjoyed, and I enjoyed thoroughly your speech. Back to you.